Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, today we are going to talk about a very interesting topic which is called paralinguistics. Now, what do you mean by paralinguistics? Let me give you a little brief on it. So, if you've heard last time what we spoke about verbal communication and its types, last session was completely about that, or last video that I spoke about was completely on that. Today, we are going to learn on not only how to communicate, or not only what kinds of communications are there, but also how to communicate in this. So it's very important, friends, to have the correct paralanguage or the paralinguistics, which is nothing but the tone of voice. So today's entire video is on the tone of voice or the voice modulation, as we all know and we've heard about somewhere or the other. So, last video that you saw was completely on assertive communication. Friends, everyone knows that now the positive attitude or the positive behavior comes out of assertive communication. Last examples were something that we, you know, talk and keep our viewpoints in consideration, keep the other people's viewpoints in consideration. But there are certain empathy sentences that also make our sentence sound like that. Now, these empathy sentences are maybe looking forward to see you soon, good morning, Mr. So-and-so. Even these small things make a lot of difference when we say the entire sentence. Now, when we say all this, there is also, why do we say this? There are advantages of assertive communication. Now, suppose if you are an assertive communicator, there are certain advantages, like it helps us to feel good about ourselves and others in the team. It leads to a development of mutual respect. Definitely, if you're going to keep other people's viewpoint in consideration, it's always going to help develop a mutual understanding. It increases our self-esteem. So people respect us, therefore our self-esteem is always high. It helps us to achieve our goals very easily. Goals, friends, this is the main thing. If you have a goal to achieve, you will definitely start working towards it. So it's my advice and a tip to all of you to have a certain goal in your mind set up where you know what path are you really walking to. It minimizes hurting people and it maximizes aligning people towards you. So this is your increase and the decreasing ratio of getting into people. So you are a complete people's person is what you would, you know, experience after getting into assertive communication. It reduces anxiety. So every time you do not get nervous because you're already there and you're so confident about it. So your anxiety level is also very, very less. It protects us from being taken advantage by the others. And since you are equally emotionally intelligent, people do not take your disadvantage. Not really advantage, but people don't take your disadvantage. Now, it enables you to make decisions and free choices in life. Now, it also helps you to become the best decision maker in life. And it also enables you to express a wide range of feelings and thoughts. Your feelings, your thoughts, considering people's feelings and their thoughts. So friends, these are all the different advantages of assertive communication. Now, with this, how can you make this sound really good? So today's video is completely going to, we are going to talk on paralinguistics or paralanguage of assertive communication. Let's see what all can we do to have the correct paralanguage while we communicate. Now, since you see, the paralanguage consists of different concepts or different aspects. Number one is, it's completely paralanguage. First of all, it's important to know what is paralinguistics. Now, these are your voice tone, your voice modulation, completely the tone of your speech and your inflections. Now, the volume that you speak, the number one, the most important is the volume. So the loudness and the softness in your voice is very important. It's very important to keep the proximity into mind. Last videos, some videos back, we spoke was about the proximity level. Now, these are the distance zone of our space between two people, between the crowd. So, and we also studied different zones in our videos sometime back. Now today, we are going to focus on how the volume or how much sound are we supposed to have with these kind of different proximities. Loudness or softness is very important in your voice. Now suppose if I'm standing in front of a crowd of around 200 people, I'm definitely going to have my volume and pitch at a little higher level. But at the same time, if I'm talking to one-on-one, very close to someone who's sitting right across to me, very close to me, I'm definitely going to have my voice at a little lower level, because then it will be like screaming on top of my voice. So this is the volume that we have to maintain. The loudness in our voice is very important. Sounds and speed of our voice is the second most important aspect when we talk about paralinguistics. Now speed is the space in which we speak. Now suppose if I speak very fast, like yesterday I had bread and butter and I had so much fun and blah 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 blah. Oh my god, it's just gone out of my head. So the pace at which I'm talking is very important. And suppose if I'm talking very slow, especially the passive communication happens that way. And suppose if I'm talking, oh good morning, yesterday I had bread and butter, I went to this office, I had my day, so lousy. We don't like to listen to something like this, right? So our pace of our speed of our voice is very important. It's really important to talk in a certain pace, not very fast, not very slow. So speed of voice is the second most important aspect of our paralinguistic. The third one is the intonation. Now the intonation is the rise and the fall of our voice. Now there are certain points where my voice rises high, and there are certain points when it goes a little low. Rising high means something that I'm talking about which is very interesting and I want to pressurize on those points. That is the time when my voice would raise high. Like, yesterday I went for a picnic. It was amazing. So here, if you see, the picnic and the amazing are the words which I want to convey. And so I have put a pressure on those two words rather than putting pressure on the entire sentence. So these are my certain intonations, or I would say intonations points, where I change the raise of my voice. There is a fall and there is a raise of my voice when I want to convey certain messages. This is the third and the most important paralinguistic aspect. The fourth one is the tone of voice. Now tone adds feeling to your speaking. Now suppose when I want to specify this, I would say, my friend who had a very late or setback at home, she's passed her father and she's come today to the office. And I would say, I'm really sorry to listen to this and my heartly condolences are with you. Now, this is something that I'm completely specifying or empathizing or sympathizing with her. And this is when I use my feelings into my voice. This is my tone of voice when I talk about feelings getting added to my tone of voice. So this is something which is sad and depressing, but at the same time, there can be a happy news and a good news as well. So the good news was, yesterday I got a promotion. So I would say like, wow, amazing, I got a promotion yesterday. Now this is like, I have added my tone has completely changed. It's more cheerful now. This is my voice tone. The way I changed it along with the feelings with my speaking. So friends, this is the fourth and the most important paralinguistic aspect, which is tone of voice. The fifth one comes the pronunciation. Pronunciation, the manner in which the word is uttered. So pronunciation, today we really goof up in pronunciation. That is because our voice and accent with the pronunciation and words are not rightly set. Not many people use the correct pronunciations, and it's very important to have a correct pronunciation whenever we speak. The manner in which we talk a word, it all depends on the way we talk the word, the style of our speaking. It should not be monotone. We will definitely we'll be focusing more on our pronunciation a little later. The fifth and the most important aspect of paralinguistic is the pronunciation. The sixth aspect is the articulation. Articulation is the clarity of your voice. No matter how fast or slow or, you know, monotone it is, it has to be very clear. The clarity of a voice is very important. Now suppose if I'm, you know, prepared a big lecture and I'm sure it would work, but what about if it is not clear? I'm not able to convey it clearly. Again, this is a very important aspect of paralinguistic. This is the paralanguage of communication. This is the sixth and the most important aspect of paralinguistics, or tone of your voice. The seventh most important is the pause, a break while we are talking, a break while we are speaking. Break is very important because if we do not have full stops and commas in our textbook, it is very difficult to know where should we stop and where should we start again. So imagine a textbook without a comma, without a full stop. How would it sound? It would sound such a monotone, as if, you know, there were lectures going on without a halt. So it's almost breathless speaking, which is almost not possible. So that's why we have these pauses where we take breaks at certain points in our sentences for being more specific on our speaking aspect. This is the second last aspect of our paralinguistic, and the last one is your punctuation marks. Now, the punctuation marks is the use of your conventional symbols and speeding in communication. It's nothing but correct symbols used at correct places. There are fillers, if you've heard about. Fillers like, oh, it was a beautiful day. Wow, what a beautiful dress. Now, these are certain punctuation marks which make your sentence sound a little more lively. It fills full of life. So, these are certain punctuation marks which you use as symbols and as spacing in between your communication. So friends, these were major important aspects of paralinguistics. Paralinguistics are actually called the paralanguage of communication. It's very important to know this, because otherwise the words, even before you speak that, you have to set your voice tone right. If you see the pie, again, the pie says 38% of the entire 100% is your tone, the voice tone, which is nothing but paralinguistic. So friends, today we've understood how important it is to have the correct paralanguage aspects while we are communicating. Only being an assertive communicator is not important. The way you put it up is also very, very important. Friends, a small tip to you. Today, you have to go to your internet and find out in Google, our best friend, about empathy sentences. When you type empathy sentences, there will be a lot of sentences which would come to you. These sentences are the sentences which would make your communication assertive. So friends, this was the entire session about paralinguistic today. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching this video. Please stay tuned to our channel, and you can also press the bell icon. Thank you very much.